Dementia in India 2015, an overview. Many families in India have someone with dementia at home even if they don't know about it. They face many difficulties trying to support the person with dementia. This presentation provides an overview of the current prevalence of dementia, problems faced by families, and future estimates which show that the impact of dementia is going to increase. This presentation also includes suggestions on how families living with dementia can be supported by institutions and by ordinary persons, every one of us. In 2015, an estimated 41 lakh persons above 60 years of age have dementia, that is 4.1 million. That is, 3.7% of the persons above 60 have dementia. If we pause to think about all the persons around us who are above 60, we will realize how widespread dementia already is. In households where at least one person is above 60, someone has dementia in one of every 16 such households with a senior. Dementia also occurs in younger persons. Young onset cases are very difficult to recognize, but experts estimate that if we add young onset dementia cases, this would add 2 to 8% to the number of persons with dementia. Many of us do not recognize how widespread dementia is around us. This is because most persons are never diagnosed. Underdiagnosis is a worldwide problem. It is very high in India. A study shows that in India, only 10% of the persons with dementia receive any diagnosis, treatment, or care. So dementia affects many families in India, even if we are not aware of it or do not notice it. Such persons are cared for whether or not there is a diagnosis. What does dementia care involve? Most forms of dementia are irreversible and progressive. The initial symptoms are mild, but the person's state gets worse over time. Dementia affects more and more of what the person feels, thinks, and can do. Towards the later stages, the person becomes almost completely dependent and finally dies. Unfortunately, because of the lack of diagnosis, many families experience the dementia getting worse but do not know that these problems are being caused by a disease. In India, care of persons with dementia is almost always done by family members. These family members include young and old persons in the family and men and women. The care required keeps increasing as the dementia gets worse. It keeps needing more and more time, money, and effort. Families face many problems while trying to support the person with dementia. There are many reasons for this. One major problem is the extremely poor awareness of dementia in our society. There is a lot of misinformation and stigma around dementia. There are also many misleading myths. Dementia symptoms are often wrongly assumed to be part of normal aging. When persons with dementia show changed behavior, they are criticized as being crazy or stubborn. Or neighbors or friends may say that the person is absent or vacant. They may behave as if the person does not know anything or feel anything. The families get criticized and blamed too, because persons around the family think they are being cruel. They may even think that the family members are greedy and are mistreating the person to grab the wealth. Or they may think that the family is neglecting the person. The help available from healthcare professionals is also very limited. Awareness is poor even among healthcare professionals. They may not recognize dementia symptoms. They may not know how to interact with someone who has dementia. There are very few specialists who can diagnose or support dementia care. The Dementia India Report 2010 calls this low capacity the most significant barrier in dementia care in India. Look at the very low number of specialists as given in the report. These specialists include psychiatrists, neurosurgeons, neurologists, psychiatric nurses, psychologists, and social workers. For example, we have only 2 psychiatrists for every 10 lakh Indians. That is 2 psychiatrists for every 1 million Indians. All put together, the specialists across India who can diagnose or support care for dementia are so few they could be fit in less than 2 basketball courts. Keep in mind too that these specialists work in many areas related to mental health and brain changes. Dementia is just one of the many problems they support. Given the poor awareness all around us, the stigma, and the poor support even from health professionals and specialists, it is only natural that most people remain undiagnosed. Even those who are diagnosed are usually diagnosed only after the dementia symptoms become more worrisome. As a result, families do not get the benefits of diagnosis and the treatments and care that may have helped some of them, especially in the early stages. There is no counseling or training. Information needed for effective care is not available. Families may not get any time to accept dementia or plan for it. Let us look at the services available for persons with dementia. For the 41 lakh persons with dementia in India, the current capacity of daycare and full-time care suitable for dementia is estimated as less than 2,000. This is so low that it is hardly visible in a pictorial representation. Essentially, dementia care in India is done at home. Unfortunately, families get no financial support or income security to help them through years of caregiving. They don't even get practical advice for dementia care suited to home care realities in India. There are hardly any support services, and even the few that are available are beyond the reach of normal Indians. Providing care under such circumstances affects caregivers in many ways. As the care goes on for many years and keeps increasing, families make major changes in their lives to take out the time and the money they need for care. They are so busy with care that they don't get time to socialize. They get isolated. The stigma associated with dementia increases this isolation. Also, family members see the person deteriorate. This is a person they have known for years and for whom they have feelings. Watching this decline is heartbreaking. The care work is hard and tiring and leaves the caregivers no time or energy to look after their own health or well-being. Stress and depression are common in caregivers of persons with dementia. As we can see, families supporting persons with dementia face major challenges throughout their many years of caregiving. How is the impact of dementia expected to change in the coming years? India is aging. The proportion of older persons in society today is higher than what it was earlier, and this proportion will keep increasing. This is also called the graying of the population. One reason is that the life expectancy is increasing and persons live longer now. Someone born between 1950 and 1955 had a life expectancy of only 36.62 years, but someone born in the period 2010 to 2015 has a life expectancy of 67.47 years. And life expectancy is improving. So persons born in 2045 to 50 will live even longer. The proportion of older persons is also increasing. In 2015, persons above 60 years of age were around 8.9% of India's total population. By the year 2050, the 60 plus age persons will be an even higher proportion, 19.4%. This is a big change and will be visible when we look at the people around us. Dementia is higher in older persons. Prevalence doubles for every 6.6 years of age. So for persons in the age group 60 to 64, dementia is seen in 1.9% of these persons. But if we look at persons in the age group of 75 to 79, then 8.3% of them have dementia. For the 85 to 90 age group, prevalence is 23%. And if we consider the 90 plus age group, 44.1% of them will have dementia. Because India is aging and the dementia risk increases with age, dementia will become a higher challenge over time. By the year 2050, around 133 or 134 lakh persons in India will have dementia. This is an increase of 225% from what it is today. Compared to this, the overall population will increase much less by around 30%. This means that the impact of dementia on families will be much more. We can expect the situation and the challenges faced by families supporting persons with dementia to increase a lot in the coming years. Given this situation, it is clear that families living with dementia need far more support than we have right now. This need for support will keep growing. A lot needs to be done. The government, various experts, corporate entities, volunteers and NGOs can contribute in many ways. There should be a focus on dementia through policy and programs. More research is needed to develop medicines. Caregiver support programs have to be developed and implemented. More professionals need to be trained. Awareness needs special attention, as do systems for early diagnosis, so that families can benefit from drugs and counseling and can plan how they will cope with dementia. Information has to be available in multiple languages and in many ways so that it reaches many people and is understandable. Caregivers need training on effective ways to support persons with dementia. There is also need for affordable services and products for families living with dementia. Dementia centers are required. Service providers should be regulated to ensure their standard of service. Families also need support in the form of counseling and financial support. There are also many ways in which all of us can help, even if we are not experts or volunteers. We can remain alert about dementia symptoms in ourselves and persons around us and consult doctors early. We can make sure that persons with dementia remain a part of normal life in our families and society, and that they can be safe and remain active to the extent possible. We can do this by getting together to make our society a dementia-friendly society. We can talk openly about dementia and care and share stories and tips, and thus remove the stigma and secrecy around dementia. We can help families living with dementia in small ways and big ways, depending on our ability. For example, we can help with chores or spend time with the person with dementia or give company to a stressed caregiver. We can contribute our time, skills and money to various organized dementia initiatives and research studies. We can all make a difference if we realize that families living with dementia are facing enormous amounts of challenges and small actions of ours can help them. This brief overview of dementia in India shows how many families are living with dementia and facing difficulties, and how these problems will increase given that India is aging and the risk of dementia goes up with age. It is a call for action for all of us to be more alert and informed about dementia and to see how we can cope better with it and help others cope better with it. We and the persons around us will all need this support and help. Thank you for listening.